The meat puppets are here. Gary came in and told me we were all set for the meat puppets. And I asked Fred, what will they, what switch on my console here should I hit so I can hear the music of the meat puppets? He said, don't worry about it. You don't need to hit a button.
And then what happened?
And then Scott walked in. I said, what button do I hit? He goes, I'm not ready.
Oh.
So I still don't know what button to hit.
And
Baba Booey tells me everything's fine, but meanwhile it's not. It's not set up at all.
Baba Button.
Baba Booey, come here, will you? Help me out. You're the producer of this show. What would you do if you were me? Some vacation I had, huh? What?
You can bring the meat puppets in.
Yeah, let me hear this, yeah?
Yeah, you bring the meat puppets in. If you talk to them for two or 3 minutes, they'll be ready to perform soon after.
What would I have to do, take another break?
No. No, not at all.
Oh, okay.
No, you don't have to take another break. Howard, it's a very simple setup this morning. They're not plugging in a lot of things.
I see. I still don't know where I'm supposed to pull them up.
Scott was supposed to tell you that last break.
All right, but he didn't.
When we're ready to go, Scott will come in and push the button up for you. So
why,
that you won't have to worry about it.
Why can't he tell me what it is? Oh, my God, I tell you.
Papa Bullhai.
That's my Baba Booey.
Me?
I love it. You know, I'm writing about you in my new book right now.
Good.
I'm on your part.
Good. Well, I read Robert's part.
You know how many times I used the word dummy in this chapter?
Well, is that the only one you can spell?
Yeah, that's right. Remember you walked in on me and said I was typing?
Yes.
I was writing about you. What a dummy you are. Thank you. I figured out why I don't like you. And I'm writing it in my book. I'm not going to tell it here on the air.
You really don't like him?
No.
You mean to pick
you? You know what? I sat there and I'm writing all these nice things. Gary's really a nice guy and all that. I go, listen, this isn't interesting. Why don't I be intellectually honest in this book? Why do I hate Gary? Here it is. Big hairy cap, teeth, lips, gums.
Hey, listen, man, I'm sorry your vacation sucked.
You should be very sorry.
I am sorry.
You should wish I was in a better mood.
When your life sucks, my life
sucks. How is your life? How is your life? Everything
sucks.
Good? Good.
Your life sucks, my life sucks.
Good. It's going too good. That's all right, Gary. It's going to change soon.
How could you change it to make it any worse?
You'll be working for Wayne Siegel.
Goodbye. That'd be pretty bad.
That's how bad it's going to get. It's going to get worse when your wife leaves you.
Well, you are an angry meat.
Get out. Get out of here. Go get the meat puppets together.
They're ready.
You sure?
You have to say, Gary, bring the meat puppets in. That's all you need to do.
Gary, bring the meat puppets in. Let's see what happens.
Aren't they going to play out in the hall?
I don't know. I don't know. I can't
get
an
answer. Scott,
when are you going to tell me what button to hit? You going to climb over everybody?
It's a secret.
It's a secret. Hi, guys. I'm sorry I'm in a foul mood.
Oh, good.
I've been writing a book for a week.
I'm glad you
And my wife doesn't understand it.
I, too, am in a foul mood.
Good. Come on. Sit down and relax. Hey, guys. Come on in. How you doing?
Yeah,
I know how you feel. Believe me, I feel the same way.
Are there only two meat puppets?
No, there's three meat puppets. First of all, there's Chris. I'll refresh everyone's memory. First of all, that's Chris.
Hello, Chris.
Chris is plays bass. Got glasses. Now he doesn't have the glasses.
I took them off.
Took them off. Good. I'm glad you took them off. Because I don't want you to clash with my look.
No, you got the shades here.
You guys brothers? I know I always ask you this.
You are one handsome guy, by the way.
You are brothers, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, you guys look identical.
They are brothers.
Yeah.
There was a rumor that they were.
Last time they weren't brothers. And, of course, Kurt, the lead singer of the Great Meat Puppets, who, you know, we know. Last time I saw him, he was in a dress. Dressed a little more conservatively this time.
It's interesting that two brothers would be in the band.
Why are you saying that, Robin?
Sometimes brothers are competitive, you know.
Oh, these guys are very competitive.
Yeah?
Oh, they don't like each other at all. Don't like each other at all. Meat Puppets, very angry band. Look at you guys.
Filled with hate.
So you guys miss me or what?
The
Get close to the microphone, for God's sake.
And don't lie.
And don't lie.
Our lives without you have been an empty void.
They have. They've been a high-priced excursion into alienation and depression.
And by the way, on drums, of course, is Derek, who's out in the hall.
Okay, that's who's out in the hall.
Hey, man.
Isolated. Exiled.
Hey, where's the other guy in the band? With the blonde hair.
He's in Chicago. He was our touring guitar guy last year.
Oh, so he's not for real.
He's not a real meat puppet?
No, he was. We just hired him last year.
Oh, I didn't realize that. He was a cool guy.
Yeah, yeah.
He was a salaried guy, though.
Oh,
we haven't really, like, parted ways. We don't know what we're doing yet.
He was a salaried guy?
Yes.
When are you guys going to get some salary?
That guy got his money and ran.
Yeah, he got his money and ran off.
The finer things. We get to...
Are the meat puppets doing okay?
Yeah, we're doing okay.
Everything
okay? Wait a minute, didn't they just do an album? Who plays?
Yeah, they got a new album. Put on some headphones, boys. What's the matter with you?
You know what, Howard?
What?
I used to play in a band called Victory Acres, and I played one of those things right there.
One of these?
One of the sound.
One of these little sound gizmos? I can play this.
That's yours.
Swing it around, and
yeah.
It's a really fun little thing.
What is it, Scott? Yeah, oh, this is very professional. Thank you. Remote one. I'll go look for that. I'll go look for that. Thank you. Only asked you 900 times. Get out of here. Dummy. Anyway, where was I? So I said to the meat puppets the last time they were here, which was like 100 years ago, I said, you guys are a professional band.
Yeah, they were a young band then.
You guys are really good. I said, why don't you take my songs that I did in sixth grade, convert them into real songs? They said, okay, man, we'll take a look at it. And I never heard from them again.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, other bands are now recording my music. I told you guys to hop on this.
We had no idea how competitive the music world really was.
Because the Meat Puppets were mad. They said, hey, wait a second. We thought that we were doing your song.
It was as if you had commissioned them.
Yeah.
They don't realize. He didn't ask anybody else. They just did it on their own.
They did it on their own. I was trying to tell you boys to jump on top of this. It's big.
Lawsuits willing to.
Yeah, well, anyway.
By the way, they have a person outside the window who's looking at you with love in her eyes.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, who's that?
Oh, Tammy. That's Tammy Levin. She's our manager.
I thought that other girl was your manager.
Which other girl was that?
That blonde, or no, the brunette who was with you last time.
That Howard was my girlfriend, and now she's my lovely wife.
Oh, no
kidding.
Michelle.
Yeah, I think you asked her.
I thought she was coming on to me.
Yeah. She was.
She was.
We're into that kind of thing.
I think I could have nailed your wife. No offense. So that's your real manager?
Yeah.
Yeah, hot black chick. I dig that. Mm, look at that.
She was just staring at you.
There she goes. She's gone now.
Hey, bring her in here, man. Who cares about the meat puppet? Bring in some girls. I've had a week alone with my wife.
Rarely have I seen someone staring at you like that.
Are you attracted to me? I'm attracted to you.
Definitely.
Nice bippy shirt.
Like
showing off that belly.
I wore that just for you.
I love when girls show their bellies. Ooh. Oh, yeah. Yeah. No hair on that belly. I like that.
Yeah. This is a new
you should have married her.
this T-shirt here features my artwork. And
is that the Meat Puppets art shirt?
Yeah.
I mean,
another
T-shirt.
One.
Yeah, very nice.
Keep slipping these.
I've never seen that T-shirt.
You date white guys or just black guys?
I don't date guys at all.
Oh, you're a lesbian? Oh,
she's into the white guys now.
What a waste.
She's into the white guys.
Oh, is she? Are you lesbo, really?
No.
Not?
No.
You date white guys?
Yeah.
Wow, cool. I had a feeling you might date white guys.
Oh, yeah.
I can tell.
You can look at them and tell, huh?
You ever date a black guy at all?
Oh, of course.
Screwed you over, right?
What?
They messed you up, right? Right? They didn't treat you right.
No.
They don't know how to treat their women right. No. They're too rough. No. Black guys are very rough with their women.
Oh, listen to you.
Oh, yeah.
Here you go with your generalizations again.
White guys are pussy whipped.
Oh.
Black chicks dig white guys.
They're easy.
Yeah. Plus, we'll do stuff to you. That black guys won't, right?
What's that?
We're more sensitive to you.
That?
We'll do stuff to you that black guys won't. You know what I mean?
We'll support you.
Is that true or false?
No, actually,
that's right, we'll support you. No, seriously, is that true that white guys are a little more sensitive to your needs sexually in terms of...
Oh, absolutely not.
You know, using their mouth?
No. Oh, no, that's not true.
That's a myth?
That's definitely.
I don't know about that.
Howard has been living with that as his only hope. Sorry.
What happened when you dated black guys? Did you get...
I'm just not right now.
You're more attracted to the white man?
I'm in the white man's world right now.
Okay.
She doesn't see any black guys.
I'm in the white man's world myself.
That's why you're only dating white.
You're
right. Stuck there, too.
You're not kidding. I'm trying to get out of it. Well, you're a very beautiful woman, I must say.
What happened?
Good thing you were off mic.
What happened?
So did you ever date any of the meat puppets?
No.
How did you become their manager?
How did you become the manager of the meat puppets? Did you have sex with any of the meat
puppets? No,
nothing like that?
Their old manager, I knew him for a couple years.
Oh, really?
And I just came out here and started working for him.
So what happened? You guys fired their old manager? Guys, doing an interview. Doing an interview.
The artists always get distracted if you stop interviewing them.
I think the meat puppets are jealous that I'm interviewing the manager and not them.
No, it was exactly like that. Yeah, yeah. She worked for our old manager, and then. And then we went.
She and I have had sex.
Really? No kidding.
Once we went over.
Lucky. Oh, I'd love to have sex with you. You know I've never had sex with a black woman?
Yeah, I've seen
it. You figured that out? How did you know that?
You must have heard about your sex life. Oh, man, now I can hear.
I'd like to take you... Can I just say something to you? I'd like to come to your apartment, sit down, sort of have some cool breezes, lifted lilies.
I got big windows, too.
They have big windows, sit there, maybe. I'd like to meditate with you. I would like to meditate with you and relax and shave you.
Oh, no.
Cook for you.
You know something I...
No, I would like to cook for you. I would love to cook some sweet champagne, some peaches.
I see your aura is what you're saying. Foot massage.
I'd like to foot massage you.
There you go.
I would love to.
Boy, you're super, I'll tell you that. Well, God bless you.
I would like to twist your head around backwards. Eviscerate you and take a bath in your organs.
I would like to eviscerate you. I would like to chop your head off.
That was last night.
Sex with the top of your head.
Can I
kick you in the stomach after I impregnate you? Thank you. And throw you down some steps.
Absolutely.
It reminds me of a thing that Derek said once, Howard. He said he's pro-abortion, but he's not pro-choice.
Right. Make it the man's choice.
Yeah.
Exactly. Anyway, the guys have been you're a very beautiful woman, and I really would like to date you. Are you involved in a relationship?
Yeah.
You are. Long time?
She's lying. She's quite available.
Really? Is that true?
I don't have time. Yeah, no.
You don't have time? Exactly. What? With me, it takes 30 seconds. Plenty of time.
That's not a relationship. None of anyone's business.
All right. That's true. All right, let me get back to the boys.
Okay.
Drummer just fell asleep. How come he's out there? Can I hear you at least?
Yeah,
you all right?
He has a problem with, well, wind.
All right. Let me talk to you guys. You guys have a new CD out, and, you know, I want to talk about that. It's called Meat Puppets. And the song is
originally
called... Is the song called Scum or the whole album?
That's just the single Scum.
Just the single of Scum?
Yeah.
Was it about me?
Well, not in a general way, yeah. But, you know, not specifically.
But let's talk about this song that you guys worked on for me. You heard my music. Let me just, for anyone who's new to the show, in sixth grade I had a band. What song did you guys work on, can I ask?
Silver Nickels.
Silver Nickels, Golden Dimes? Yeah. Oh, good. Now, I always thought this was my best song ever.
Is that you singing that stuff?
Yes. Thank you.
Oh, man.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you.
Woo!
Blew you out, huh?
Have you played that stuff on the air?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, I had no idea.
Yeah, that's me, man. Thank you.
They hadn't heard it before.
You never heard this before? Let me play a little of Silver Nickels, Golden Dimes, so people at home know what you had to work with.
Mary.
See?
Come play with me.
I hope you left this in.
I'll give you Silver Nickels.
You wonder why it took them so long.
I hope you were true to the song. You're another one like me. Oh, no, I love this song. This is my best work.
Oh.
Is this rocking or what?
I'm just looking at the paint on his face.
Hey, Kurt, not everything you wrote is a winner.
What'd you write, your sixth
grade? Nickel. Silver. Now, Kurt, why are you laughing, man? What's your problem?
life is such a joke.
Put that away.
You get a cherry.
Do you like it?
Yeah, I'm about to lose my virginity sitting
here. All right, now wait a second. Were you guys you guys worked on a rendition of this?
Yeah.
Did you get the drum solo in?
Well, it's up.
Well, let me just play the drum solo part.
My favorite.
I hope the drummer took notes. This is the part that I like.
You wrote this too?
I worked on this, yeah. Back from time to time, giving you those silver dimes. This is about prostitution, by the way.
He couldn't even tell what it was about. He just moans every time you say something about the song.
A car accident had more rhythm. So you guys didn't know that was about prostitution?
No.
That's what it's about silver nickels and gold and dimes. Everyone knows it just wants money all the time, man. You know what I mean? Even though they can get sex for it.
Kurt just thought it was a big mess.
You ever thought about what it was about when you worked on it?
I don't think that much in general.
Really? Really?
No, I just...
Would you guys like to do your version of it now?
Yeah, if you want.
Oh, yeah, I'd love it.
Okay.
All right, great. Well, here's some real music.
I can't wait to hear what they made.
Now, you'll see that this is a good song. Let me just see.
Is it a good song?
See if your bass is working.
Well, yeah, I think it's a good song. I think we got... you know, which was which here? This is my vocal one here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Cool.
All
you want some echo?
Yeah.
I can give you that. A little echo. I don't want to overdo it. All right, here is Silver Nickels, Gold and Dimes, done by the Meat Puppets. Yeah.
All right.
The boys, of course. Derek on drums, Chris on bass, Kurt, lead singer, and guitar. Give me a check. Check, check. Let me hear that bass. Oh, good. Drums.
I don't either.
Sounds better already, though.
I don't know what they're playing.
You sure this is my song?
Oh, yeah. We just changed it a little bit. We were true.
Now I hear drums.
And there'll never be another one like me. And now you.
No, 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 you do it.
I'll do it.
I'll be back from time to time, giving you those silver dimes. I will be your soul. I will be your gold. Silver nickels. Thank you.
were right. That was the way the drum solo was supposed to sound. Beautiful, right?
I loved it. I just
beautiful song.
It's a great ballad.
It's a beautiful ballad. Beautiful. Excellent.
Thank you. I after I listened to it, I said I just want to slow it down a little bit because I didn't want to.
I was surprised you slowed it down. I would have guessed you would have gone faster with it.
It's just too early in the morning.
Really?
Yeah. I feel so peaceful. So I don't know. Luxuriating.
That took me by surprise.
Basking in
there's a lot of love in that song.
It was almost like a heroin song or something. Like a guy on heroin.
Yeah, it was real slow.
You guys aren't on heroin, are you?
No. It's...
Hey, you know what, man? I was checking out the. I didn't know this, but I was watching MTV Unplugged.
Uh-huh.
And Kurt was up there with Kurt Cobain.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
On that Unplugged thing.
Yeah.
I didn't know that.
He was there, too. Chris was there.
Were you? I didn't see you up there.
I'm the...
Were you guys playing? You guys were tight with Nirvana?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah? I didn't know that.
No, we
never tight. Really met him. We did a tour with him, and we were just talking about cover songs and stuff, and the guy said he wanted to have us come on TV with him and play some of our old songs.
That was pretty good.
Want us to play one of those oldies for you?
What do you want to play?
Play Oh Me.
Was my song hard to play?
It was extremely difficult.
Seriously?
Yeah, it was. It takes a lot of work to get to that point.
What do you mean by that? No, seriously, I'm curious.
Where it sounds decent? Is that what you're saying?
No, I don't understand. I don't understand what you're saying.
You generally arrive at a cover song, you know, by just... You just feel the need to do it, so it's something, you know.
So you didn't feel the need to do it.
Well, you give it to me, and I have to listen to it and find the need within myself.
Right? Did you find that need?
Yeah, I did.
It just took you a long time.
Well, I just had to consider it to the point where how would I do it?
Right.
You know, how would I do this without just imitating it?
Right. Well, all I know is, you see,
it sounded real good to
there
me.
There you go.
I liked it.
Silver Nickels,
thank
Golden
you,
Gods.
Robin. Yeah, I really liked it.
By the way, the Meat Puppets' new album is Scum.
No, that's the single.
Well, they should call the whole album Scum.
You know, when I saw the single cover, I said to myself, that should have been the album cover. My daughter did the album cover.
Is that right?
Well, not that. The album's called No Joke, and it was the picture she did. And then.
Well, it's very good. Very, very nice. What do you guys want to do? You want to play something out of here, or what do you want to do? What?
You know, I think that they originally worked up a version of Psychedelic B, but just decided not to do it when they heard the other one.
Oh, really? Is that what happened?
No, uh-uh.
Is that not true?
That's true.
That is true.
Wait a minute. You guys make up your mind.
It's true, isn't it?
No.
It's not?
I don't know it, no.
We would like to do an expressive, interpretive version of it nonetheless.
Well, you really want to do Psychedelic B? All right, well, go ahead.
That one down
there. Did you speed it up? Guys, what is it you want to do here? I'm not following the program. What is it?
I don't know. What were you talking about?
What were you talking about?
I have no idea.
Oh, you were just saying stuff. All right, let me listen to the CD to them.
Okay.
All right. What was that you played on MTV, though, with Kurt Cobain?
Those are three of our old songs here from an album we put out in 84.
Oh.
Meat Puppets 2.
Yeah, it was good. It was good.
Would you like us to play one of those, Howard? That's what I was offering to play.
Oh, do you really want to? I can't tell.
Sure, whatever any of these. I love playing. Personally, I love music.
The manager is saying something that they should do, but we can't hear her.
All right, bring in that foxy black chick. What's her name?
Tammy.
Tammy?
Tammy with a T.
Oh. Hi, Tammy.
Hi.
How are you? How old are you, by the way?
32.
32? That's a little old for me, but...
you have somebody you'd like to introduce her to?
Yeah, I can introduce you to somebody.
You gotta stay away from those people.
I love your body. What, do you jog?
Nope.
That's all natural? Whew. I wish you'd be my manager. Dump these guys. I'll double whatever they're paying you.
Not Robin.
What?
I'm not managing anything.
No. You'll be managing my sex life, Tammy. That's what you'll be managing. Yes, it's time for you to have sex now. All right. Well, I believe you're right. That's a little true. All right. Anyway, Tammy, what song were you suggesting the boys do?
Oh, me?
Oh,
yeah.
Oh, Tennessee Stud.
Yeah, I want to play Tennessee Stud.
It's about time you did that. All right. Here's the Meat Puppets.
I thought you were going to play the single. You're not going to play the single.
I was going to play the single, but you guys are doing this.
Play the single first, then I'll play Tennessee Stud.
Yeah. All right. Well, here, let me hear a little of it. I don't want to sit here and play records all morning. I got more important things to do, like talk about the FCC.
The beginning of it's the part with the encoded.
Are they bothering you, Howard?
Yeah, why don't you guys write a song about how the government is up to all kind of nonsense.
Hey, Mr. FCC man, why don't you just leave Howard alone?
Yeah, well, keep making jokes. Yeah, make jokes.
Everybody thinks it's funny.
Everything's funny.
That was a serious protest song.
Let me see what your CD
Straight
sounds like. Real quick. Here we go. Ready? What's the name of this song? Scum?
Scum.
No, what's it about? Seriously, come on. Give me a break.
The FCC.
Is it?
It's about scum.
All right. Well, I'm against scum. Hmm. I wish this thing worked. I would play it.
Let me hear this.
I can see the equipment hasn't been fixed since we left. Well, I don't get anything out of the CD player as usual. That Tom Chiasano, he's a real card.
What's this?
I think it's the CD decided to start playing. Wow. Hey, you guys are rocking on this one. I like what I'm hearing. What are we, 10 seconds into this and I'm digging it?
Not even.
This is very hard rock, and that's what I like. There's the voice I like. You know what I dig about you, man?
Here comes the voice I like.
When you sing,
yeah,
you hardly even put any effort into it. That's what I like.
You're right.
You can hardly care.
These guitars and everything screaming. And you go,
it's like that's cool, you know. That's the epitome of cool.
That's as much energy as I have.
You know what's good about that? It's like, you know, hey, I got a record contract. I'm doing something that most people never get to do in their lives, and I don't even care. I'm just gonna get up there. I'm gonna do whatever I got to do. I love that. I would be like so hyper about it. I'd be like,
you're just singing and competing with your guitar.
Oh yeah, I would be like, hey, come on guys, lower your guitar. This is good. Very contemporary. Different. Oh. Beautiful. It's a hit. Son of a bitch, you came up with a hit.
I thought a beautiful thing, the fire that was in my mind.
Got a video for this?
Not yet. We gotta get busy.
I might direct it for you. We'll talk to me about that after, Tom. I won't charge you much.
What?
I don't have time. Dumb. This is good. I really like this. I'm not just saying it because they're here. Probably about Steve Leeds. Dumb.
Who is that guy anyway?
Yeah.
This is
a good part. Who's playing that?
It's the front one turned around backwards.
Wow.
That was Paul Leary's idea.
I'm thinking of going on heroin. What do you guys think about that?
Good choice.
Shake.
You need to drink lots of orange juice, though.
Wow. You like this? Don't say it just because the guys are here.
No, I really am digging it.
I'd air guitar to this. Want to see me play to this?
Uh-oh.
I can play to this. Watch. I don't need a guitar.
I saw a beautiful thing, the fire that was in my mind.
Wait, I gotta get my foot pedal going. How come when you guys, how come every guitar player plays live and they're always messing around with their feet, like always hitting some pedals and stuff on the floor? That's cool.
And not only that, you know, dials and knobs
and
everything.
It's always like cool stuff you do with your feet. I always like, that's what, when I play air guitar, I'm always like, I'm on the floor, I'm more like, you know.
You know what that is?
What?
That's actually more like rats leaving a sinking ship.
I know what's going on there. That's to like impress girls. That's to look cool.
Like it makes it look more complicated than it is.
Yeah.
It's actually cockroaches leaving a failing musician.
No, I don't think so.
Trying to slam them.
Look at me. Watch me play air guitar. Watch. Notice I don't even pay attention to what I'm playing. I'm busy with my feet. See? That's the move. I like this song. We find the scum. Who wrote this? Son of a bitch, you did it. This is one I'm getting behind. I'm on the team now. I like it. I gotta write a song.
And you did.
I know. It's a disaster. I got to get in a band. Where are you guys playing? Anywhere I want to get up on stage with you again. See if I can jam with you. Notice the invite isn't there.
Leaping anytime.
Yeah. Where are you playing? You're the manager. You're supposed to know. They're supposed to be burnt out.
We're playing in Charleston, South Carolina.
I wouldn't go there.
16th. Yeah, we're playing in how about this? Norfolk, Virginia.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
I wouldn't go there.
Howard, next time we're in town, we'll give you a call.
Thanks.
And you can come down and play with us anytime.
Yeah. Well, hey, thanks. We'll do a Silver Nickels Golden Dimes together. I can play that.
The way they did?
Yeah.
You want to hear Tennessee Stud, Howard?
Yeah, sure.
Talk some
yeah, okay. You want to talk some more?
You want me to play?
Yes. All right.
Yeah, play us out of here. I got to get some work.
Shut up and sing.
Yeah, that's what you guys are trying to, you know, get the whole thing up. These are the Mead Puppets. They're a pretty incredible band. They're real good. What do you want to give us a number? Excellent.
Yeah. Here we go.
I want to thank you, by the way, for doing my song.
Yeah, you're welcome. It was our pleasure.
Didn't sound like you put that much effort into it, but you did good.
Come on, I like that.
Did you like that?
Yeah.
I don't know, man. They told me
because it wasn't rock. They turned it into a ballad. I like that.
They told me they rehearsed it on the way over in the cab. They never even got together and worked on it.
That's where he got that.
They didn't work on it. They didn't.
You know, that's how we did our album, though.
Did you really?
We didn't rehearse it. We just went in and played. I taught it to him the day before. We
showed me how to do it out in the hall.
I like this new song, Scum. I really do.
Thanks.
I really like it very much. All right, let me hear a live combo work.
Okay.
Let me make sure you guys sound right. I don't hear nothing.
You can't hear?
Do you hear bass?
Not yet.
Okay.
That's the bass. In 1825, I left Tennessee very much alive. Would have made it through the Arkansas mud if I hadn't been riding on the Tennessee Stud.
Yeah.
Had a little trouble with my sweetheart's pa. One of her brothers was a bad outlaw. I wrote a letter to my Uncle Fudd, and I rode away on the Tennessee Stud. Well, the Tennessee Stud was long
and lean, the color of the sun,
and his eyes were green.
See, I know this one.
He had the nerve and he had the blood. Never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
Yeah!
Yeah. Down in the no man's land across the river called the Rio Grande. Huh. Raced my pony with a Spanish foal till I won me a sack full of silver and gold. And the Spaniard, we couldn't agree, and we got in a fight over Tennessee. Pulled my pistol and it fell with a thud, and I rode away on the Tennessee Stud. Well, the Tennessee Stud was long and lean, the color of the sun and his eyes green. He had the nerve and he had the blood. Never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
Tennessee Stud was long and lean.
Yes, sir.
The color of the sun and his eyes were green.
Not unlike the Tennessee Squirrel.
I never know what these guys are talking about.
Always chasing right over my head.
They got their own little language going.
I went back to Arkansas, whipped her brother and I whipped her pa. Found a girl with the golden hair, she was riding on the Tennessee mare. Little baby calling on the cabin floor, little full coat playing round the door. I love the girl with the golden hair, and the Tennessee Stud loves the Tennessee mare. Well, the Tennessee Stud was lonely, the color of the sun and his eyes green. He had the nerve and he had the blood, never was a horse like a Tennessee Stud. Well, he had the nerve and he had the blood, never was a horse like the Tennessee Stud.
Wow. You guys are good, man.
Thanks.
I dig you. I dig you, bastards. You know that? I think I predict big things for you. I thought they were going to segue into Silver Nickels, Golden Dimes.
Oh,
let me tell you something. You'd be wise to put that on your next album, Silver Nickels, Golden Dimes. You did a nice rendition of that. Think about it. Yeah, you can laugh now, but I'm telling you, that's a big hit.
It really is pretty the way you
last
do it.
Night, I'm telling you what, Tammy was mesmerized.
Was she?
She said the same thing you were saying about Scum.
That's right. It's a damn good song.
She said you have a hit there.
Thank you. Scum is real good. I want to thank my friends, the Meat Puppets, for stopping by.
Certainly.
Thanks for having us.
Good luck on the road, wherever the hell it is you guys go. I don't know where you go.
The road.
We'll see you in Virginia and various places. When you come to New York, I want to get up and jam with you guys again.
Absolutely.
We'll do Silver Nickels, Golden Dimes. Nice rendition. Thank you for doing that. That's an honor.
You're welcome. It was our honor.
Exactly.
I still don't know how it got done.
I don't either.
It's a question of honor.
I don't know. I think it got done on the cab. I don't know. But all I know is it was good.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys.
You're welcome.
And we'll be back right after these words.